Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Hello everyone, welcome back to the PL-300 exam preparation series, where we are going to look at the practice questions. Since the last video on the practice questions, these are the topics that have been covered. So the topics are mainly related to DAX. So the first topic is create calculated tables. Then we have covered implement time intelligence measures, create semi-additive measures, create a measure by using quick measures. So these four topics pertain to the DAX programming or developing measures or exploring most of the stuff around DAX. Then the other topics are configure the report page, identify and implement appropriate visualizations, apply and customize a theme, format and configure visualization. So this last topic is still continuing. We have covered around three or four parts of this particular topic, but there are a few parts which are still left. So these are the topics that have been covered since the last video on the practice questions. So now we are going to go and have a look at the practice questions. Before I actually go and talk about the practice questions, there are a few important points to consider that probably you need to just go and revise or have a detailed look at from the documentation that has been referred in the video. So these are a few DAX functions. Format is filtered, is in scope, and some of the logical functions if, switch, and or. So it is almost impossible to cover everything in DAX. So we have tried to mainly cover the topics that are important from an exam point of view, but there are still a few functions of DAX that you just need to just go on DAX.guide or any other website and have a look at some of the syntax and the format of those particular functions. So these are the functions that I would highly recommend that you go and just note down what these functions actually do. So now let's go and solve the practice questions. Question 12. You are a data analyst at Litware Incorporative, tasked with creating a Power BI report to analyze sales data. The management team wants the report to be visually consistent with the Litware's brand colors. You decide to use a custom color theme to meet this requirement. To align the report with Litware's brand colors, which of the following steps should you take in the Power BI desktop? So these are the four options. In the View tab, select Themes and then customize current theme and manually adjust the colors to match Litware's product brands. The second option is use the format pane in each visual to individually set the colors to the Litware's brand palette. Option C is import a JSON file with Litware's brand colors predefined under the Themes option in the View tab. And the last option is adjust the default color theme in the Power BI service settings to match Litware's brand colors and re-import the report. So let's have a look at the options. So the answer is option C, which is import a JSON file with Litware's brand colors predefined under the Themes option in the View tab. And the explanation for this is that this is the most efficient way to apply a consistent set of brand colors across an entire Power BI report, and this can be done by importing a custom color theme. This can be done by creating a JSON file that defines all the necessary colors used in the Litware's branding. Once created, this JSON file can be imported into Power BI desktop by going to the View tab and then selecting Themes and then choosing Browse for Themes. This approach ensures that all visuals in the report automatically adhere to the brand's color scheme, maintaining consistency and saving time compared to manually adjusting colors for each visual. So this is a very elaborate explanation, and it's kind of explain everything that out of the four options, this is probably the most suitable option, that if you want to import the brand color for this particular brand Litware, then you can import a JSON file that has already these colors and these can be applied on all the visuals inside the Power BI report. Question 14. You need to add a measure to rank total sales by products. The result must appear as shown in the following table. So this is going to be the structure of the table. So which DAX formula should you use? So we have four DAX formulas, all of which use the rank X function, and we have to pick one option which is the correct one. So let's have a look at the correct answer. So the correct answer is option B, where we have the product ranking is equal to rank X, and inside we have the all and the product, and then we have the measure, and then DESC, which is actually represents the order, and then we have the dense value selected. And why we have selected this dense? Because here we see that the rank is equal for the values where the two products have the same sales amount. So you, if you remember that we discussed this in detail, that we have two options. One is the skip option and one is the dense option. So if there is a tie in terms of the values, if two values are equal, then the same rank is given to the same rank is given to the particular product or to the particular category in the visual. And in case if we had skip, then it would have been a different value because the next rank would have been skipped. So this option B, based on the rank X syntax, is the correct answer. So again, if you know the syntax of the function, then even if you do not actually know something which is part of the question, then you are still able to answer the question correctly. Question 15. Litware wants to analyze their sales data over the last 5 years in Power BI. They are interested in identifying trends and patterns over time. Which visualization should you use in Power BI to best represent the sales trend over the last 5 years? And the options that we have are pie chart with sales data divided by year, line chart with years on the x-axis and the sales figures on the y-axis, stacked bar chart with each bar representing a year, and last option is tree map where each block represents a year of sales. So let's look at the correct option. So the correct answer for this is a line chart with years on the x-axis and the sales figure on the y-axis. And the explanation says that the line chart is the most effective visualization for displaying trends and patterns over time. By placing the years on the x-axis and the sales figures on the y-axis, it allows for an easy interpretation of how sales have evolved year over year. This type of visualization is ideal for identifying upward or downward trends, seasonal variations, and other time-related patterns in the data. So the explanation is quite comprehensive because the question says that we want to identify trends and patterns, and we have seen in the videos that line chart is the best visual to actually show the trends. So we will have the line chart with years on the x-axis and the sales figures on the y-axis as the correct answer to this question. Question 16. As a data analyst at Litware, you are creating a Power BI report to display the monthly sales performance of different product categories. Which visualization would be most effective for comparing the monthly sales performance across the different product categories? So the product, so the options that we have include a pie chart showing the proportion of sales for each category per month, line chart with a separate line for each product category, stacked column chart with each stack representing a product category, and a scatter chart with months on the x-axis and sales on the y-axis with points colored by category. So let's look at the correct answer. So the correct answer is option C, which is a stacked column chart with each stack representing a product category. A stacked column chart is ideal for this scenario as it allows for the comparison of total sales per month while also showing the sales distribution across different product categories within each month. This visualization makes it easy to see how each category contributes to the total sales and to compare their performance side by side. So the explanation is kind of self-explanatory because we want to display the monthly sales of different product categories and so sales performance. So kind of we are doing a comparison because here it says which is the most effective visual for comparing. So for the if you are comparing, then obviously a stacked column chart with each stack representing a product category gives you the most effective visualization in terms of seeing the comparison. So that is why option C is the correct answer to this particular question. Question 18. You need to write a DAX measure that returns the revenue for selected dates during the previous year. Which two DAX functions should you include in the measure? So we have to pick two functions out of these four so that we can answer this particular question. So let's have a look at the answer. So the answer is calculate and same period last year. So we have already seen this pattern in some of the other questions, that whenever we want to have the revenue or some other measure based on the calculation on the previous period. So here we have a previous year. So similarly, here we can see that the option has one function which has same period last year, that kind of goes with what is there in the question. And obviously calculate is always going to be there. These two time intelligence functions are not relevant for this particular question. So this is the correct answer for this question.